When teachers make judgments about a dimension in an individual response, they will match the evidence for that dimension with the syllabus standards. They will make an on-balance decision about the best match of the qualities of the student work with the standards descriptors at a particular standard.
When we set assessment, we would design an instrument-specific standards matrix or a criteria sheet. What that means is that we would identify the general objectives that are being covered by that particular assessment instrument, remove the ones that are not pertinent to that particular assessment instrument. Then we look and see which elements we can identify within the task that we can include into that standards matrix. So for example, if we were talking in science about motion, then instead of just saying concepts, we could say concepts to do with motion.
The starting point is to look at the standards at the A, B and C level, and to look at the different words or the words that discriminate between one standard and another. So for example, I know in one of our standards and conceptual knowledge and conceptual understanding, there's a difference between complex and challenging for A standard and complex or challenging in the B standard. Now, through my professional experience and discussion, I've come to understand that that indicates a level of depth in the response and a breadth in the response. So by looking at that particular discriminating word, I find I gain, a mental concept of what the difference between an A and a B response looks like, and then I look for that difference in the student response.
Okay, well, I would take the student's response, and as I'm reading that response, I would have alongside me the stated criteria, and then I'm looking for really point addable evidence of each aspect of the criteria being met by the student at the level at which the student is meeting it. So particularly when looking at VHS, A quality work or VHS standard work, really trying to identify clear examples in student work of where I can see corroborating of evidence, evaluating of evidence, different perspectives being referred to, and insightful judgments being made.
It's important for teachers as professionals to have professional conversations, because as they talk with each other and they look at student work, they're able then to look at the qualities of the work and see how they match to the standards descriptors. And so they then have a shared understanding about what that work looks like and what the standards look like in practice.
I'd like to have a look at this student here. He seems to be getting a pretty good result in knowledge and procedure, but it's only at a B standard about here. And as you go through there, you can see that the level of work that they're doing and the sorts of things that he's been asked to do, the complexity is getting more and more. As you go along there a bit further, I can see that that sort of model that he's trying to deal with there is at a fairly complex level. Would you agree with that?
Peter, I saw this pretty much the same. When I started to read it, I thought, okay, rectangular distribution, this is going to be pretty straightforward, it'll be a solid B. But like you, as I kept reading, the complexity started to come out later on in these pages here. So I think in terms of applying the mathematical definitions to a complex task in that life-related situation, I think that definitely meets the dimension, the standards required.
So you're happy for me to give him an A in that particular area?
Yeah, I think so.
So if we
yeah.
just give an A in that particular criteria which was being developed at that particular one, about a standard A there?
Well, I think so. I think there's no doubt it's a B, absolutely no doubt. Mm-hmm. But I think you could argue that this work here
yep.
definitely meets the requirements of the A standard when it comes back to that complex task mm-hmm. in a life-related situation. That's exactly what the students produced there, I believe.
Good. Well, if we go on to standard in the criteria modelling and problem solving, you can see that the student has actually dealt with the assumption and their effects. And I think they've done a pretty good job with respect to explaining themselves, showing what has happened as a result of the assumption being changed, and moving on from there. So I would say that while the identification has happened, they've also looked at the effects.
I would agree. As a matter of fact, this would be one of the better examples of a student response to that particular dimension, because often students will list what they believe is the assumptions, but not actually talk about the effects and how that would change the model.
Good.
And I think that's what this student's done here. If mm-hmm. you look through here, if the cars were allowed to travel, etc., finally it was assumed that, and so on.
Yes.
So all of the parts of the problem has been addressed in that solution. Then he goes on to talk about the strengths and limitations and lists a clear strength and a clear limitation, again, without just making a bald statement. It actually reflects the mathematics of the situation that the student's using. So I think that, yeah, I agree. I think it's definitely A standard.
There's also an aspect of the refining of the model, probably not as effective as the other two areas, but nonetheless he's made an attempt at dealing with that particular area. So I think there is some refinement that's being added to in this particular one. So I'd be looking at being an A standard in that particular area as well. Would you agree?
I would agree, because sometimes what you don't want is a student writing three pages that have not much meaning because they believe that, oh, well, I've got to put a lot down here to meet this A standard. Yes. Well, it's not about that. It's actually meeting that attribute,
yes,
which the student's done, even though it's only a couple of sentences.
Yes. Good. Okay, shall we have a look at the communication justification as well?
Yes. What were your thoughts?
Well, it's fairly concise and coherent. So I think that they're working towards that A standard again, certainly within respect to the reasoning that they've been applying. It's not too verbose. There's certain aspects that could be maybe a little bit smaller, but not much. And I certainly see that they've actually responded to the levels that might be in there from complexity and non-routine sort of stuff that they need to deal with there. So the justification of those is dealt with in an appropriate way. The decisions were quite clearly laid out, and there seems to be a process and a modelling of what we would have seen in our classroom discussions as well. So I would suggest it's also about an A level.
I'm very comfortable with an A standard for this work in communication and justification, and I take your point about the conciseness of the logical justification that the students put into this work.
Yes.
So I agree entirely.